do you think it's best to encourage people to change their routine? I think that's something that most people don't do. They've got their routine of how they're going to handle a muskie. This is what I do. I'm gonna catch it. I'm gonna get the hook out, hover away, and then I'm gonna bump board it, and then I'm gonna photo it or whatever it is. And you know, just is there anything besides the obvious hemorrhaging, besides the water temperature? I think we really covered that with the water temperature. It's extremely important, but is there anything else to say, hey, I gotta change my routine here. I gotta stop everything and maybe let this fish go right away.
It's hard to put a finger on that. Just the fact that we're talking about it, you know, and we need to educate ourselves. And I think the biggest thing is, you know, like you said, you get in these routines, we all do. I think the biggest thing is to realize we're caught in a routine and start thinking about, you know, look at those fish, you know, if you stay in your routine, does it have those, all that pinpoint hemorrhaging udders? It's like, well, I better do something different. You know what I mean? When you see those signs, that should be the first indicator that, you know, this probably isn't a good practice, at least at whatever time of year you're at, and I need to do this differently, you know. You're just putting a simple bumper on the end of that floating stick. That's a nice change. That's a nice change to the routine that we, instead of bumping them on boards, and I'm not against boards. I mean, I've put hundreds of thousands of fish on boards in my former career. But I think we have to try and break out of our routines. Because there's more muskie. People muskie fishing, I think, in the last 5 to 10 years, which it's great to see, you know.
Really good point. You know the other thing I'll point out too, that the average muskie angler you see, especially in the last decade, is so much better than they used to be. I mean, guys like me were used to be head and shoulders above the majority of the people. That's not the case anymore. The majority of the muskie anglers I watch out on the water these days are very good. They've got the technology, they've got the knowledge, they've got the great rods and reels. They're just gonna encounter a lot more fish. It's hard to hide if you're a muskie these days with the quality of the anglers.
Well, there's just so much more, you know, with social media and YouTube and, you know, with the internet age. I grew up before there was the internet. There's just so much more information readily available. I think that's why it's important we have these conversations, you know. That, again, this is information that will become available for people and give them something to think about, you know. Maybe we should do things in a little different way than we have been. You know, I've tried to consciously, you know, because I grew up, when I was a teenager, you know, I've never kept a muskie. I honestly can say that going back 42 years. Even back then, it made sense to me to release them. I'm not exactly sure why. I never had a dad that taught me that, but it just made sense to me. I guess that's why I became a fisheries biologist early on. But, you know, we definitely didn't know anything about handling. You know, we had those nylon mesh nets, which I'm sure knocked about half their mucus off. And we didn't have the cutting tools and, you know, the extra long-handled needle noses and stuff. You know, we just had a slip joint pliers, you know, so we undoubtedly probably killed some fish even though we released them, you know, just from lack of technology and information.
Yeah.
We did the best we could at the time with what we knew and had, but that wasn't very good, really, to be honest.
Well, you know, one of the big problems, too, as far as, floating rulers kind of went out of popularity. There has not been a lot of good options available. One thing that we did the last couple days that a friend of mine, Rob Manthai, has been doing for a while, is he weighs them. And he's gonna take a photo anyway, especially in the fall. He's like we are. If he doesn't fish in hot water and a really stressed fish, he's just gonna let it go. But if he gets a photo, all you gotta do is hop on a scale. He brings a bathroom scale. We did that yesterday.
Yeah.
And and you, as long as you measure or weigh yourself, it doesn't even matter if the scales had dialed in. You weigh yourself with everything you got on, then you grab the fish out of the net, and you're holding it for a photo, you get on the scale, you do the math.
Yeah.
That's another real accurate way, and I think we're gonna see more in-water type measurement systems come about because of this awareness.
I was even thinking about, you know, you could rig up a board, you know, like we used to just take yardsticks, but you could come up with even that, and you could rig up like a little armature for it with like a couple, not pontoons, but a couple, you know, things with that pipe insulation, you know, that foam pipe insulation. You could zip tie that to it, make it floating, and it's almost like a board in the water, you know, that you can, with a bumper on the end, and you can slide the fish, you know, right into it in the water. If you still wanted to have that kind of board system,
right?
Probably, I mean, I know you could come up with something that is floating in the water, but the fish is partially submerged, and you know, so they're in the water, and you know, but that works just as slick too, just a bumper on the end of a floating stick. I'm sure there's lots of different things people undoubtedly, I hope, come up with, you know, as we move forward, to shift those systems into, you know, in water floating systems, so you don't even hardly have to take the fish out at all.
Yeah, there's up. For people wanting an accurate measurement is understandable. It just really, you know, there's definitely a better way to do it that'll really help preserve the fishery, I think.
You know, and another thing you talked about is girth measurements. You know, that's a whole nother, I think I would try and stay away from girth measurements in warmer water, you know.
Definitely.
If it's cooler, you can, like we said, we're pretty sure you can get away with more. And, you know, cooler water, it's probably fine, but in warmer water, it's probably something we need to not do anymore, you know, or at least minimize it, you know.
Europeans have been weighing them for years in special slings that they have, and actually this clam colossus net we developed with a cradle in the bottom of it, so you could literally use the net
as a
way to get a weight as well. And originally, that was why everybody started with the girth measurement and length measurement, so they get that together and they do the formula so they could estimate the weight. Why not just get the weight? Because it literally takes 3 seconds.
Yeah.
And that bathroom scale idea that I did yesterday,
that's simple and easy.
It worked great.
Yeah.
And if you're gonna hold them up anyway for a photo, it's the same amount of time out of water.
Step on the scale and you're there, you know. That's a great idea. I think people are pretty ingenious once they decide they want to do something a different way or a better way. I found people are pretty amazing. They'll come up with some pretty ingenious ways of doing things better, you know, different and better. So I suspect it'll be interesting to see, you know, hopefully in the near future, some different ways of, you know, measuring. And the bathroom skills, you know, pure common sense genius, you know, that's you know, that's a good old farm boy, you know, genius.
I kind of like that old-fashioned thinking.
Yeah,
actually, I like Rob's idea. Just pop on a bathroom scale.
You know, simple is, a lot of times, the more simple it is, the better, you know. A lot of times, you can overthink it, I think, too, sometimes, you know. Keep it simple, as they say, and that's the KISS principle. And, there's a lot to that.
That's my kind of science, Tom.
That's legit, you know. There's nothing wrong with that. If it works, that's all that matters. That's all that matters. No studies needed. No validation needed. It works.
So, yeah.
If we could figure out how to make fish bite, then we'd really have it licked.
Yeah.
fall's always about windows, and they're usually fairly skinny.
They are skinny in the fall. The old fall feed bag thing is probably true, but it certainly doesn't happen all day.